Hi, my name is Tanya. Welcome to SAF Integra-E Configuration and Installation video series. By the way, E stands for a very high frequency range starting from 71 up to 86 gigahertz. In this episode, you will get familiar with Integra-E interfaces and will also prepare the radios for the bench tests. This is how Integra-E looks like out of the package. The part number on the label here indicates that this particular radio is the low side. And the low side radio transmits in the frequency portion 71 up to 76 GHz. The other radio unit I have here is the high side, and that one transmits in the frequency portion of 81 up to 86 GHz. Now let's take a look at the ports of the unit. These two ports are SFP plus, that's for fiber optics connection, and the speeds supported are up to 10 gigabits per second. This port here is RJ45 electrical, it's a gigabit Ethernet port, and it also supports PoE. Then we also have an option to apply the DC power separate on this port. There is a 2-pin DC connector in there. This port is a service port. It has LED. LED acts as an indicator for RSSI. The more frequent blinking indicates a stronger RSL. There is also a USB-B port which acts as a serial interface, and there is also a 3.5 millimeter jack that can be used to attach the voltmeter and do the alignment. Or you could also attach the headphones and hear the beeping signal. The more frequent beeping indicates a higher received signal level. Let's look at the RF port here now. You are going to receive the unit with the label on it, which needs to be removed before you do the bench tests and installation. You can see that we have a very small circular waveguide flange here, and there is also an arrow pointing to the left, which indicates the polarization. So this particular unit is in horizontal polarization. If you need to change the polarization, these four screws need to be removed. The adapter needs to be rotated by 90 degrees. At all times, during the installation, the unit has to be placed with the handle on the top and the connectors on the bottom. So now for the bench test, if you don't have the test kit, don't worry about it. There is an option to use an office paper pack, place it on top of the unit, and place your other Integra-E unit on top of it. The office paper pack is sufficient attenuation. So our test kit is now ready to go. We only need to apply the power to both of the Integra. To apply the power, I'm using SAF provided PoE injectors and also SAF provided AC to DC power adapters. I have prepared the connectors. Make sure when you crimp them that you connect the minus sign on the left and the plus sign on the right side. This connection, dated plus power, is the port that needs to go to Integra to power it up, and the port on the left side is going to go to my PC. So now I'm going to apply the power to both of the Integras. So you can see the green lights are lighting up on the Integras, and you can also see that my PoE injectors are showing all green lights. That indicates that there is a load. So at this point, the setup is ready for the configuration. We can connect the PC and start configuring the unit. Thanks for watching. If you have found this video useful, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.